Hello, I'm Matt and welcome to Badger Workshop. With summer just around the corner, I need a way of transporting my beer to all the barbecues I'm going to go to. So today, I'm going to make this wooden beer crate out of bits I've just got knocking around the shop. So, let's get started.
I love to use bits of recycled old pallet wood, so let's find some suitable bits in my collection. I need boards wider than any I have, so that means I have to glue two together to make one wide board. To hold the boards together, clamp them up some speed clamps, many clamps you can get on it, both directions, and leave it overnight to set up. The next morning, with the glue set up, the clamps can be removed, and then I'm going to run it through a planer to get it nice and smooth. Now I want to determine how high my sides need to be. I want them just slightly taller than the tallest beer bottle I'm going to use it now. Now using the chop saw, I can chop both the ends for it and the base. Now I'm just going to roughly draw out the shape I want the ends to be. Now using the bandsaw, I'm going to cut out the shape I want the ends to be. I can use the first one as a template, then to cut the second exactly the same. With the ends and the base cut, I now just need to determine how long the sides are going to be. I'm just going to hold them up and mark it with a pencil, take it to the chop saw. Get the saw lined up to my pencil mark, then using an old bit of railway line, I can use that as a stop block so every cut will be exactly the same length. Glasses on and ready to make the cuts. I want the slats on the side of the crate to be different thicknesses, so I'm just going to rip one piece down on the table saw. I'm going to crisscross some wood inside the crate to keep all the beer bottles separately, so I'm just cutting some thinner wood down to make this. I need to mark out where the slots need to be cut so all this wood will crisscross together nicely to hold my beer bottle safely in place. first mark in the area that needs to be removed. Now using the bandsaw, I can cut out the waste material. With a little help from a chisel, I can just pop out the waste. The last job before we start construction is giving everything a sand down. The crate needs a handle on it, so I need to mark and then drill a 16mm hole ready for it. If I can get the cap off, it's time to glue it all together. To hold it all together as the glue dries, I'm going to use a nail gun and some brad nails. As this is a beer crate made out of old bits of pallet wood, I think it's safe to say this is a rustic project. So, I thought I'd continue with the rustic look. By using a blowtorch, I'm going to distress and age the whole of the crate. The finish I'm going to apply is medium brown wire wax. I apply it just using a paintbrush, then you've got to leave it to dry, and when it's dry I just buff it off using a brush I have mounted in my drill. For the handle, I'm going to use a bit of old copper pipe. This bit's been sitting around a while and a bit tarnished, but some wire wool brings it back to brand new. Strangely enough, a pipe cutter is by far the easiest way to cut some pipe. It gives a really nice clean edge. On the end of the pipe, I'm just going to fit a solder ring 15mm end stop. All you've got to do is heat it up with the blowtorch, the solder will run, cool, and it'll be fixed on. Now I can thread the handle through the crate all the way up to the end stop. Mark where it needs to be cut and then pull it back out again. The pipe can be cut on the mark that was made and then threaded back through the crate. The other end cap can be popped on and then soldered on in the same way as the first one. It's no good having a crate of beer and having no means of opening them. So I put on a bottle opener, marked the holes with a bradawl and then screwed it on. That seems to work. Thanks for watching, and for more projects, please subscribe.